Good day everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel today. My name is Benga Akindele Adetitun David. I come to speak to you today as promised on the reason why you should not travel out of your country illegally. Reasons why you should not travel to the United States of America, to France, to Germany, to South Africa, to England, United Kingdom, or any other country, or even Canada, any advanced country, reason why you should not travel out of your country illegally. Some people travel out of their country without the proper travel document. That means they smuggle themselves into another country. Some travel through the road or they go through Morocco from Nigeria through Morocco, then they get into Europe. All these are not good ways to travel. Some people don't go through that route, but they travel as tourists. They have tourist visa to go to UK or other countries, and when they got there, they do not come back at the time they ought to come back. All these have its disadvantages. All these have its disadvantages. It's good to travel as a tourist. You are given 3 days, given a month, given 6 months. Within that time, you go properly, you come back properly. Don't go there and overstay. The moment you overstay, the system abroad, they have a system and they have proper records such that when you overstay, you may not be tracked down. But the moment you get back to your country, you cannot travel back to such a country that you have overstayed again. Why? It's not a thing about the simple reason is that they have proper records. So the moment you go to the embassy, they see your passport, they input your passport number or your name, it will show them that you have traveled before and you did not come back at the right time. It will show your records. Now, some travel as tourists and remain without proper documentation. Some people travel to other countries as tourists. They travel that they want to go and see how America is. They want to go and see Tulsa, they want to go and see Washington DC, they want to travel to go and see Oklahoma, they want to travel to go and see how Stillwater is. And the moment they travel, whether they travel, they want to go and see how London Bridge is, they want to travel to London, they want to go and see how Paris is. Some people see Paris and die. They want to see how those countries are. It's good to go as tourists. But by the time you get there, what do you do? One of the things that you should do is come back at the right time. Some people don't come back at the right time and they don't have proper documentation to stay. When you travel as a tourist and you want to remain in that country due to some reasons, you've seen that the country is a good one, fine. Go ahead and do proper documentation. Get a lawyer to help you to find out what you can do so that you can have proper records of remain in that country, and you can start doing this before your tourist visa expires. Don't wait until your tourist visa expires before you start doing that. I've had cases of people that travel as tourists and the tourist visa have expired. If they come back to their country, they will not be able to go back to that country again. So what do? They remain in that country and they keep trying to get the appropriate documentation. Why don't you get the documentation right ahead? Why don't you get the right documentation on time? Get it done on time. All this can be sorted out for a fee if you have a good immigration lawyer that can help you to handle that. You can do that easily. But some people overstay and then they do not want to pay the right fees to the immigration lawyer that can help them. So they keep moving on and hiding. What happens is that somebody, the agent that knows about you not having your proper document is going to feast on you. It's going to feast on you in the advanced country because it's even possible the agent have taken your passport, may even take your passport, and you remain at the mercy of the agent. The agent help that such individual to get some work, to do some work on the ground. But the money comes to the agent, or the individual gets the money and must settle the agent. So it's like you are living, paying double tax One to the government, the second one to the agent who is helping to do your papers over there, your illegal papers. So avoid doing this so that you don't fall into wrong hands. I have cases of people who have traveled for so many years and they have families in developing countries, but they are unable to return to their country because the moment they come out of the advanced country, they will not be able to go back because they don't have proper documentation, they have overstayed. And the record will show, and they are going to be blacklisted the moment they get back to their country. So they keep on struggling. And so these are leading people to marry other women in such countries in a bid to get citizenship. All this can be sorted out properly. Number two, another thing is that some travel on medical grounds. They travel, they say they have a kind of medical ailment, and they get a certificate from government hospital, from a government doctor in a government hospital, who certify that they should go and see a doctor in abroad. They should visit a clinic abroad, and they agree. On getting there, perhaps they go to see the doctor truly, but they now refuse to return to their country. They may give them 3 months, 6 months visa, or even a year visa. After it has expired, they refuse to come back. What such people should do is to go ahead and do proper documentation in the right way and maybe seek an extension. Get a good immigration lawyer who will help you to seek an extension. And by so doing, you can be able to come back to your country and still go back to that country, or you can be able to remain longer in that country with proper records and with proper papers. Another thing is that some people travel to study and they remain in the country where they have traveled to study. You travel to study for 3 years and the visa is 3 years. After 3 years, they refuse to come back to their country. Or if they're given additional 1 year, or they're given additional 2 years, then they refuse to come back to their country. What happens in such situation is that they also will be blacklisted. They may not pursue you and catch you inside of the country, but you are sure that you have limitation on what and what you can do in that country. Why are you living in a place where you are going to be limited? You've left the developing country and you are going to the developed country. So why are you going to create a limitation for yourself in the developed country that you are traveling to? Let us avoid that. Another thing is that don't leave what you are doing previously. You are traveling out of your country and you have a job, even though you say the job is not paying you fine. You have a job you are doing in your country. Don't leave that job. If you want to go and see how the developed country is, you can get your money ready and then go on the tourist visa and see how things are. You can go 2 or 3 times or 4 times and be solidly sure that everything things are going to work out before you eventually leave your country. You can plan it over a long period of time. Don't just leave your job and go to another country. I will suggest that if you have a job you are doing in your country, try to read the book Acres of Diamond. Acres of Diamond. And you are going to be understand what I'm saying, and you are going to decide for yourself. Another thing is that don't travel if you have no skill or expertise, or if you have no education. You have no skill, you do not learn any trade, you do not go to school, you don't have any skill. Please, do not travel if you have no skill. Do not travel if you have no skill, you have no expertise, because this is what we use to sustain yourself for the meantime before you launch out fully in the developed country, or even not just for the meantime, but for a long time. You must develop skill, develop soft skills, develop different kinds of skills that is going to help you. If you don't have a skill, please, I plead with you, do not travel to a developed country. Instead, develop a skill in your country. In fact, I recommend I develop 2 or 3 skills, both soft skills and hard skills. Can you barb hair? Can you plait hair as a lady? What can you do? So many skills that are available, photography and other things that you can do. Learn a skill. Can you repair vehicle? Can you do all those kind of things? These are good skills. So if you are a graduate and you don't have a skill, go to the roadside mechanic in the developing country and learn 1 year. You are going to grab it since you are you are enlightened to some extent, in 1 year you grab it. You can learn refrigeration skill. You can go to a roadside repair. You can learn how to wire a house. You can learn all these things, and they're going to be helpful to you. Don't move if you have no finance or support. You need finance and you need support. So if you don't have finance or support, don't move. Don't let somebody to just tell you that this and that and that. You need a lot of money if you are going to survive in the developed country. Yes, you are going to be able to make a lot of money, but you need a lot of money also to settle down and to be able to make yourself comfortable in that country. So all these are advices. Remember, advices are not are something that you can either take or leave. So the advice I've given can either be taken or it can be left unused. The choice is yours. But I plead with you that don't travel illegally to any advanced country. I am going to talk to you some other time. Remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel. As you have watched now, click the subscription button right below, and then tell other people to also click the subscription button. Please, I need about 1,000 subscribers in the next few weeks, in the next few months. I have a target, so I need about 1,000 subscribers in just 2 months. So please help me subscribe. Tell your friends to subscribe so that we can hit the 1,000 subscriber target. Currently, I have about 80 subscribers. So I'm pleading with you, help me to subscribe so that I can be able to earn from the YouTube. And also, not just subscribe, watch the YouTube video for longer. I am going to talk to you some other time. Bye for now.